Would you like to see how to use Enumerate? Well, here it is. When you want to create a numbered list in Python, it's natural to use a for loop. And then when you want to add the number, you can use a counter. Sometimes we want to use the place, the index within a list. So therefore we can use range. Now if we print that, we can see that it starts at 0. So if we wanted to add one, we could just add one to the variable I that we're using to count. An alternative method is to use enumerate. And here if we run our program, you can see we've got the original 1, 2, 3, ABC, and 0, 1, 2. It starts at 0. Now if we want to start at 1, we can use 1 after the list name of letters. So now we have our 1, 2, 3, and we have our 1, 2, 3. So if we look at our code, we have similar for loop, but we put the counter inside the loop with the term enumerate. Have our list, and if we want to start at 1, we put that after the list. So we can run that again, and we have our 1, 2, 3, 1, A, 2, B, 3, C. Now we can enumerate strings as well as lists. If we change our list from letters to a string, here we've got Dr Codie is a string called words. When we run that, here we've got 1 to 8 with the letters including the spacing of the string. So we can enumerate over a string as well as a list. We can enumerate over a dictionary. Let's add a dictionary called my dict, and for count L in enumerate words, we want to change that so we have a key and a value, and we're going to change the my dictionary, and we want the items in the dictionary. So now we've got count, and we've also got the key and the value. So when we print them, we can see we have the count and the dictionary key and a dictionary value. So we can, let's say if we want to start at 1, we can just move that so that we can see the code. And here we've got 1, 2, 3, ABC, apple, ball, cat. So that's how we can enumerate over a dictionary. Now if we want to go over a list but in reverse order, we can use the word reverse. So let's run this. We can see we go through C, B, and A. Now, if we want to enumerate over that, then we can, with enumerate, we can put in the code, and we can use the same code, except for the enumerate, we need to put that into a list. So when we reverse it, we can run the program, and we can see we have, let's take out the original code, we can see we have the 210CBA. So it's possible, if we can extend that, we can see all the code. We have our for loop, we have our count and L for each member of the letters, and we enumerate as part of a list. Finally, something we'll be showing soon is zip. But just as an example, we have letters. Now imagine if we have our letters, uppercase letters, have a second list, then we could, let's put C in. So we have two lists, and we will shortly be showing how to use zip, which puts members of lists together in pairs, in tuples. Now if we want to enumerate that, we can see we have a very similar code to our dictionary, and when we run that, we can make sure we have the correct name. And we run that, we can see we have 012 ABC ABC. If we started at 1, we should be able to run that and have 123 ABC and uppercase ABC. So we've put the two lists together, each member of the list into a pair, and we have the number of that item in the list. Now time for the practice exercises. Exercise 1. Given a list of letters, print each letter and index using Enumerate. So remember that will start at 0. Exercise 2. Print each letter and index using Enumerate and start from 1. Exercise 3. Print each letter and index in reverse order. 4. Print a dictionary using the number letter of the alphabet as a key and value using Enumerate. And the last exercise, print a dictionary with the index, number and letter of the alphabet as the index, key and value. So you have the number and letter as part of the dictionary, and also use Enumerate to show the index. So you're going to have 0, 1 and A, 1, 2 and B, 2, 3 and C, up to 25, 26 and Z. Okay, so we have a look at the solutions. Exercise 1, we just have a simple Enumerate. We can run that. You can see it starts at 0. Exercise 2, we can run that and we will see that it will start at 1. You can see we just added the 1 after the list name when we enumerated for exercise 2. Our exercise 3, we reversed it. Here's the syntax, the code. So we reverse and we enumerate the list, but we make that a list as well. So we can run that, check that. You can see it goes 5, 4, 3, 2, 0, 1. Now let's move on to exercise 4. You can see we've created a string called alpha, and then we've enumerated and we put that in a key and value to print the dictionary. So we start at 0, so A starts at 0. We have 0A, 1B, 2C, 3D, all the way to 25Z. Now in exercise 5, we use the alphabet string that we used in exercise 4, and we create the dictionary first, and then we enumerate over the dictionary. Now the dictionary we started at 1, so we have 1A, 2B up to 26, but the index is going to start at 0. So when we run that, you can see we've got 0, 1A, 1, 2B to 25, 26Z. With so many videos, we really suggest you click that subscribe button and the bell to get notified when these new videos are getting released.